Now we are going to discuss about capital structure theories. Theories of capital structure. So we have different theories. All these theories will be focusing into the value of the firm. Value of the firm means the capital the firm which has. So here now we will take the net income approach theory and we discuss that, and then we can go on further theories. Net income approach. This is one of the very important theories of capital structure. This theory, in short, it says that value of the firm is depending upon the value of equity and the value of debts, or the value of the source which they have in their capital structure. So this theory categorizes a firm into two types, that is levered firm and unlevered firm. Levered firm means the firm's capital will have debts and equities. In unlevered, we have only equity capital, right? So a levered firm will have debts and equities in their capital structure, and unlevered firm will have only equities in their capital structure. So the value of a levered firm, that is V, value of firm, V is equal to market value of debt D plus market value of equity E. So that is V is equal to E plus D, or D plus E, what it may be, D plus E. So in the case of levered firm, it will have debts and equities in their capital structure. So the value of the firm, V, is equal to the market value of debt plus the market value of equity. That gives you V equal to D plus E. Market value of debts and market value of equity, we have different formulas to calculate. And in the case of unlevered firm, value of the firm is equal to market value of equity, that is V is equal to E. So in simple words, value of firm V is equal to D plus E in case of levered firm, and V is equal to E in case of unlevered firm. So this is how a value of firm is calculated. In net income approach, we will calculate the market value of the firm, and the market value of firm can be identified by finding out the market value of debts and the market value of equities if it is a levered firm, and it can be obtained by calculating the market value of equities in the case of unlevered firm. So that's what thing. Now we can discuss about the market value of equity, then we discuss about market value of debts, then we will discuss about the value of firm. First is market value of equity. Market value of equities. So it is the value of equity capital in the capital structure. So the value of equity is in the capital structure, and the formula to calculate the market value of equity E is equal to NOI minus INT divided by KE. Here NOI means net operating income, that is EBIT, earnings before your interest and tax. Earnings before paying interest and tax is what? Net operating income. INT is the interest paid, and KE is the cost of equity, that is the percentage cost of equity. So this is what the formula to calculate the market value of equities. So this you can again write it as net income divided by KE. So net income means NOI minus INT. That's net income. So this can be written as like this or like this, no problem. So this is a formula to calculate the market value of equity. The next is the market value of debts. So market value of debts means the total value of debts in your capital structure, and the formula to calculate the market value of debts, formula to calculate market value of debt, D is equal to INT by KD. INT by KD, where INT is the interest paid and KD is the cost of debt. Okay. So now we will discuss one problem which explains you how a market value of a firm is calculated by using net income approach, NI approach. The situation is a firm need to form a capital structure out of the following alternatives. The firm is having some alternatives in front of them, some three types of alternatives. From those alternatives, they have to form a capital structure. The firm will earn a net operating income of rupees 1 lakh, and their cost of equity is 10%, and the cost of debt is 5%. And you have to suggest which alternative is best based on net income approach, right? So I repeat once again, your firm is planning for an expansion, and if they expand, they will get net operating income, that is, they will get an earnings before interest and tax of rupees 1 lakh. And if they have this, they have three alternatives, and they have a cost of equity 10%, and they have a cost of debt 5%, and you have to suggest them an alternative, which alternative is the best one, and that suggestion will be on the basis of the value of the firm, that is on the basis of net income approach. So you have to calculate the value of the firm and the weighted average cost of capital, and you have to suggest the best alternatives. Best alternative. The first alternative is the company is planning to have a zero debt capital structure. There is no debts, only equities. The second alternative is the company is planning for 7 lakhs equities and 3 lakhs debts. The total investment is 10 lakhs then. 7 lakh equity and 3 lakh debt. The third alternative is the company is planning for 9 lakh debts and 1 lakh equities. So these are the alternatives, right? So money need for expansion. amount required. Rupees 10 lakhs. And if you invest this, you will get an EBIT or the net operating income, rupees 1 lakh. And your cost of equity will be 10%, cost of debt will be 5%, and you have the alternative number 1, that is zero debt, that is entire 10 lakhs by equity. Alternative 2, you are planning for 3 lakhs debt and 7 lakhs equity. That's 3 lakhs. Equity 7 lakhs. And alternative 3. Debt's 9 lakhs. And equity 1 lakh. So these 3 alternatives you have, and you have to suggest the best out of these 3 on the basis of value of the firm and weighted average cost of capital by using net income approach. This situation. So, a company is planning for an expansion of 10 lakhs. If they expand for 10 lakhs, they will get 1 lakh as EBIT. And for having this, they have 3 types of alternatives in front of them. The first alternative is 0 debt and 100% of equity. That is, the entire 10 lakhs is expanded. Entire 10 lakhs is accumulated by selling equity shares. The next alternative is they are planning for a 3 lakh debts and a 7 lakh equities. And the third is they are planning for a 9 lakh debts and 1 lakh equities. These are alternatives. And you have to select the best alternative out of these 3 on the basis of the net income approach. That means on the basis of the value of the firm and the weighted average cost of capital, because with the weighted average cost of capital is calculated to find what will be the cost. Then to find the value of by using this NI approach, we will be finding out the value of equities and we will be finding out the value of firm, and with that value of equities, value of debts and value of the firm, and based on that we make decisions. So let us go to the alternatives.